Modularity, and we shall discuss various techniques of modular design of a web application. And today our topic is using viewports for namespaces and tag helpers. Suppose you have a website that has two or three many pages. Let us say this is index 1, this is index 2, 3, 4. Now we know that on all the razor pages we need to put namespace directive. We also need to write tag helpers directive, that add tag helpers that we have to type on every page. Now this story can be shortened. We can make it more modular by using a file called view imports. This is a special file underscore view imports. This file works much like your header files in C++ or C language. You will write all the namespaces, you will write the various common directives in this file, and these directives will automatically get included in these files. So you do not have to repeat those directives separately in each of the files. So this is the topic of discussion today. Let me formally introduce you to the underscore view imports file. This is what we are going to discuss today. What this file does is, directives shared by many views may be specified in a common underscore viewports.cshtml file. Like if you have various pages and you have to write add tag helper, remove tag helper, using model, inject. If you have to use these directives in all your pages, then instead of typing them all of them there, you can put all of them inside one single viewimports.cshtml file. This is one viewimports.cshtml file. There are various, these are the only things that are written there, 4, 5, or 6 statements. And whenever this file is used or placed at a correct location that I'll come to in a moment, these directives, they will automatically get included in all of the pages. So this answers the question, what is to be written inside viewimports.cshtml file. Now let me now talk about where this file is to be placed. Viewimports.cshtml file can be placed within any folder, in which case it will be applicable to pages or views within that folder and its subfolders. So if you have a folder called pages, and in this folder you write a file called underscore view imports, you put that file here, then all the pages inside this inside this pages folder and all the subfolders in this pages folder, they will receive these directives, the directives written inside your view imports file, they will receive those directives as includes. So this is the simple story, and let us now practically take an example. I will show you how we can practically do that, then you can understand it better. So this is the solution explorer of an empty project that I have created. I have called the project modular, and these are the basically that structure is created for you. Let me start with an explanation of the startup.cs file. This is the startup.cs file where we will configure our razor pages. So let us have a look at it, double click it. And when you open it, you get this is your startup class, configure services, services.addRazorPages. This will add support for the razor pages. And after that, come to the configure method. There you have to add use routing and endpoints.mapRazorPages. This is the basic plumbing that is required for making our razor pages operational. And therefore, this is what is the basic project that is now available with us. So now I will do one thing. I will add one or two razor pages so that you can also see how we actually do them. And let us do, and then we will add our view imports file. Right click, add new folder. We will add a folder called pages. So this is the folder that I have added. All our razor pages, they must live inside a folder called pages. Right click this folder, add new item, and here we will select a razor page empty an empty razor page. I'll keep the name as index for the first one. Click add. When you click, you get these two files, index.cshtml and index.cshtml.cs. The CS file is the backing class and the CSHTML file is the markup razor file. To simplify things, I'll just remove this because my code is not going to be tough. So I have this add page directive at the top, and then I have a reference to the backing class index model. This is the reference to the backing class, the index model, and this is the namespace part that takes me to the index model class. So I'll explain it in very close terms. So this is modular.pages and this is modular.pages.indexModel. Okay. Now let me add one more razor page to it so that I have a pair of razor pages with me. Add new item razor page. I'll give it a name index 1. Click add. Again, I will remove this one. So now what I have at the moment is that I have the pages folder, and inside it I have index.cshtml and index1.cshtml. I have two razor pages, and inside the first razor page I have index 1. This one references its backing class, and this page references its own backing class. Let me close the CS files so that I can remove the clutter. Now I have open with me the index and index 1, only the two files I have open in front of me. So what I'll do is I'll put a link on both of them. That link will carry me from one file to the another. Okay, click enter. ASP page is equal to index 1 and go to index 1, and here I will write an h1 tag. This is index. So I have in case you are not aware of this, this is written with the help of a tag helper. This is anchor tag helper, and I have to specify ASP hyphen page equal to index 1, the name of the second page to which I want to go. Now let me run it and let me show you how it will work. I will let me do the same thing there also. I'll copy this part, Control C, go there, make some space, and this is index 1 so that I know that I am at index 1. This is I'm changing to index, and this says go back to index. So at the moment I have two pages. One page is index, the second page is index 1, and here is a link, here is a link. I expect to click it and go there, and expect to click and come back. This is a very simple page that I have written because I want to introduce you to the concept where I can simplify many things on these pages even. Okay. So let us now run the project to see whether we have done everything okay or not. Debug, start debugging. It will not work, I am telling you beforehand only, because I have left one important. So this is that heading, but this is not, the link is not working. Similarly for the other page, that link is not working. The reason I'll tell you is why it is not working. I'll close it. The reason is that I have not included the add tag helper directive at the top of both the pages. So let me add that directive, add tag helper. And for this directive, you have to write star comma Microsoft dot ASP.NET Core dot MVC dot tag helpers. Now this directive is required for this index link to work because this link is written with the help of a tag helper, and this directive is required at the top of this file. Now let us run it so far to see whether now the things have started working or not. It is still not working. Maybe I have done something wrong, so we'll wait for a moment. Build, rebuild, sometimes star comma Microsoft dot ASP.NET Core dot MVC dot tag helpers. So this all is okay, it should work. Debug, start debugging. Oh, I think it's not working because I've not written it inside that index page. So I'll do is I will copy it, control copy, come to this and paste it here. Now let me run it. Debug, start debugging. So now the link will work because we have added the directive. See, the link is active. I click this one. I go to index one. This is also active. I come back. So now the point is that I have two pages, and on both the pages I have a repetition. The first repetition you can see is this at model, the namespace and the tag helper. Now what I can do is I can put all these common things into one single file called view imports. So let us now see how that can be done. So these are the two files. I'll right click this pages folder and add new item, and here I will select my view import. Let us now see where is it. Razor view imports. See, it is here in this list, Razor view imports. The name is underscore view imports dot cshtml. This name you should keep it same. The name is hard coded into the system. So view imports dot cshtml. This name is hard coded into the system. So with this, let us now add this. I'll click add. An empty file gets added. You can see here that this file is inside the pages folder, and since it is inside the pages folder, if I put any common things into this file, they will become part of the other two files also and of the subfolders also. So in this file, what I'll do is I'll take this out, cut and paste it here. Similarly, on the index I will come, cut. I don't need to paste because it is, of course, it is there once only. So now I don't have the tag helper directive in index one. I don't have it in index also. And instead I have a view imports file where I have added that directive once. Now let us see whether things work or not. Start debugging. So here you can see go to index one is active, go back to index is active. This means we have succeeded in getting our add tag helper to work. The second thing is that this namespace is repeated. So what I will do is I will add a directive to this common directive at namespace. The namespace is modular.pages. So this is what it is at the moment. I have only two common things. So both of them I have moved to the view imports. And now I'm into my index one. I can remove this repetition and just get index one model. And here also I will remove this repetition. And now my both the files, they are fairly short and they can now be easily maintained also. All my things are inside the view imports file, as you can see. Now let me run it, rebuild and start debugging. So the things work as usual, and in a very big project this is a very handy thing. If you want, I can show you that without this. I'm just temporarily removing it. If I build, I should get errors because these will not be linked. This file will not be included, so it will not be able to find this and it should flag an error. So I will build my solution to see errors are there. See, I get errors because index one model and index model, they have not been resolved because I had deleted this off from here. So this is how your view imports file works. It has to be in a folder and it gets applied to all the files and subfolders in that folder. It gets automatically included. So what you can put, namespace and similar directives into this, the common ones, and your code becomes very simple. Your code becomes very simple and it becomes easier to maintain. So this is how the things work. I will close it right now. And thanks.